In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet, adding and subtracting rational expressions. Now, our directions are to simplify each expression. But in order to add and subtract rational expressions, we need to have the denominator be the same. So looking at number 1, 8v squared times u squared is equivalent to 8v squared times u squared, so we can subtract the numerator. So writing this over the same denominator, we'll have u plus 5v minus the quantity u minus 6v all over 8v squared times u squared. So now I'll simplify my numerator by first distributing this subtraction to each of the terms because I'm subtracting that entire quantity. So I'll have u plus 5v minus u, and then minus a negative 6v will become plus 6v. And that's all over 8v squared times u squared. Now combining like terms, I'll combine u with u, and then I'll also combine 5v with 6v. U minus u equals 0, and 5v plus 6v equals 11v. So I'll have 11v all over 8v squared times u squared. Now I can simplify even further because I have a v in my numerator and v squared in my denominator. And remembering the law of exponents, v to the first over v squared equals v to the 1 minus 2, which equals v to the negative 1, which is 1 over v. Another way to think of this is that since 2 is greater than 1, this v will get canceled out and that 2 will become 1 because I'm canceling out one of the v's. So again, v to the first over v squared is equivalent to v over v times v. And you can see that when we cancel out a v from the numerator and denominator, we will get 1 over v. So those are just a couple ways to think about dealing with exponents. So now that we've simplified, we'll have 11 over 8v times u squared. That is our solution in number 1. 11 over 8 times v times u squared. Let's continue on to number 2. In number 2, again, we have the same denominator, so we can go ahead and add the numerator. So that'll be 5n plus 2m plus 4n all over 30m. Combining my like terms, I'll combine 5n and 4n to get 9n, since 5n plus 4n is 9n, and then I'll add that to 2m, and that's all over 30m. And we cannot simplify this any further, therefore 9n plus 2m over 30m is our solution in number 2. So in number 1, we were able to cancel out that v. However, in number 2, we cannot cancel out this m because it's added to another term. If there was an m in both terms, then we would be able to cancel it out. However, since there's addition in the numerator and there's an m only in one of those terms, we cannot cancel out an m. Let's continue on to number 3. In number 3, we have the same denominator, so I'm going to write this over 6a cubed. So I'll have a plus 2b minus the quantity 5a plus 4b, and that's all over 6a cubed. So now I'm going to rewrite that numerator as a plus 2b, and then I'll distribute this subtraction to the 5a and to the 4b. Because we're not subtracting 5a and then adding 4b, we're subtracting that entire quantity. So we're going to be subtracting 5a and then subtracting 4b. And that's all over 6a cubed. Now I can combine my like terms, a with 5a and 2b with 4b. So a minus 5a will be negative 4a, and 2b minus 4b will be negative 2b, and that's all over 6a cubed. Now I can simplify this quantity further because negative 4a and when I subtract 2b from that both have a 2 in common. So if I was to pull out a 2, I would get negative 2a minus b all over 6a cubed. Now my 2 is multiplied to each of those terms. Therefore, I can simplify with that 6 in my denominator. So 2 over 6 simplifies to 1 over 3 because both 2 and 6 are divisible by 3. So I'll have 1 times negative 2a minus b, which is just negative 2a minus b, all over 3a cubed. And again, that's because 2 sixths is equivalent to 1 third. So negative 2a minus b over 3a cubed is our solution in number 3. And number 4, I have the same denominator. In other words, my denominators are equivalent. Therefore, I can subtract my numerator. So I'll have x plus y minus the quantity 6x plus y. And that's all over the denominator, which is 18xy. Now rewriting this numerator, I'll write it as x plus y, and then I'll make sure to distribute that subtraction to both the 6x and the y. Because we're not subtracting 6x and then adding y, we're subtracting the quantity 6x plus y. So we'll be subtracting 6x and subtracting y. And that's all over 18xy. So simplifying, I'll combine my like terms. I'll combine x with 6x, and I'll combine y with y. Now x minus 6x will be negative 5x, and y minus y will be 0. So I'll have negative 5x in my numerator over 18xy in my denominator. And because my terms are all multiplied together in both my numerator and denominator, my x will cancel out with the x in the denominator because x divided by x is 1. So I'll have negative 5 over 18y as my solution in number 4. In number 5, again, my denominators are equivalent, so I can just perform the operation within my numerator. So 4a minus 5 plus the quantity a minus 1 will be divided by 6a squared plus 30a. So I'll combine my like terms, which is 4a and a, and negative 5 and negative 1. So 4a plus a is 5a, and when I'm subtracting 5 from that and subtracting 1, that's going to be minus a total of 6. So 5a minus 6 over 6a squared plus 30a. I cannot pull out a common term from any of those quantities. Therefore, 5a minus 6 over 6a squared plus 30a is my solution in number 5. In number 6, my denominators are equivalent again, so I will be able to take the first numerator and then subtract the second numerator from it all over that same denominator. So I'll have 5x minus 4 minus the quantity x plus 6, and that's all over 9x cubed plus 27x squared. So rewriting that numerator, that'll be 5x minus 4 minus x minus 6. And that's all over 9x cubed plus 27x squared. So now I'll combine my like terms. 5x, I'll subtract x from that. And then negative 4, I'll subtract 6 from that since that 4 is already subtracted. So 5x minus x will be a positive 4x, and I'm subtracting 4 and then subtracting 6, so that will be total of subtracting 10. So 4x minus 10 is my numerator, all over 9x cubed plus 27x squared in my denominator. And that's going to be my solution in number 6, because there's not a common factor between 4x, 10, 9x cubed, and 27x. I cannot simplify those any further. So 4x minus 10 over 9x cubed plus 27x squared is my solution in number 6. In number 7, because we have the same denominator, we can simply add our numerators over that 12b plus 18. So we'll have b minus 3 plus 4b over 12b plus 18. And then I'll combine my like terms, my b with 4b, to get 5b minus 3 all over 12b plus 18. And I cannot simplify these terms any further. Therefore, 5b minus 3 over 12b plus 18 is my solution in number 7. In number 8, you can see that I have the same denominator in each of my fractions, so I can go ahead and add those numerators together. So I will have n minus 4 plus n plus 1 all over n squared minus n minus 20. Now I'll combine my like terms, combining n together and combining 4 and 1 together. So n plus n is 2n, and if I'm subtracting 4 and then adding 1, that will be subtracting 3, since negative 4 plus 1 is negative 3, and that's all over n squared minus n minus 20. That is my final solution in this video, 2n minus 3 over n squared minus n minus 20. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments below. And before continuing on to the next video, remember to like, subscribe, and share.